Hello everyone, welcome to Canadian Coins. In this episode, I'll share my experience how I obtained a spouse open work permit to come into Canada within the 10 days of application. I will show the step-by-step process I followed and the details of the document formats I used for this application. Before we start the application, I will walk you through the key documents required for this. First is international student details, proof of the relationship, and next is the client information. I will be explaining the contents of each documents in detail. The international student details, the details of the student who is already in Canada. You have to have the passport, the study visa counterfoil, which is already stamped in your passport, and the study permit of the student, work permit if the student is having a co-op, the letter of acceptance from the college, the initial letter you received from the college, and the enrollment letter which you can get from the college student website. Next is the student ID card. You have to have the transcript, like not the full transcript, the transcript which you're having at the moment. It will be an unofficial transcript which you can download from the college website. And you should be working a part-time job, and you should have to show a proof of employment from the Canadian employer. And you have to attach three latest paystubs. And also, you have to show a bank balance in a Canadian bank, the international student. I recommend to show at least a minimum of $12,000. CAD in the bank statement. Next is the proof of relationship. This is very important if you have recently married, like less than a year or so. So you have to prove you are in a marital relationship. So I suggest giving a copy of your wedding invitation letter, marriage certificate from the state government, marriage certificate from the church or temple where the marriage was conducted, signed by the name and position who conducted the wedding, details and photographs of the wedding and honeymoon to prove your relationship is genuine. Next document is the client information. In this, you have to show the applicant's degree certificates, applicant's experience certificates, the bank balance statement in a bank letterhead, and the applicant's chartered accountant asset evaluation report. This should be an asset evaluation report done by a chartered accountant at your home country, which states both movable and immovable assets you have. And next are the optional documents. I have done this for my application. I have kept parents' bank balance statement and a notary attested affidavit stating that any incidental expenses will be borne by my parents if required. Let us start our application. Google, we will go to IRCC login website. So here you have to create a new account or sign into your existing account if you have already created. So I'm going to sign in with a GC key. So if you have not created an account, go here to sign up an account. Click on the above link to watch videos in creating an account in IRCC, which I have done in previous videos. I have already created my account, so I am going to log in here now. Once you log in, you will be seeing this page. You can scroll down and click on apply to come to Canada. You don't have a personal reference code, you scroll down. So I don't have a personal reference code. You can click on visitor visa, study or work permit, because the spouse will be getting a work permit. So let's fill the questions asked here. What would you like to do in Canada? You click work. How long are you planning to stay in Canada? Temporarily, more than 6 months. Select the code matches one of your passport. Select based on your passport. I'm selecting India. What is your current country or territory of residence? Because you are in India, you have not yet arrived in Canada, so you select India. All these applications are based on the spouse who is outside Canada. Spouse is the applicant in this process. Do you have a family member who is a Canadian citizen or permanent resident? Your spouse is an international student, so you click no. What's your date of birth? You select that. Click next. Are you a lawful permanent resident of the United States? No. I have a job offer and my employer gave me an offer letter now, because you have not yet received, you have not yet arrived in Canada. But if you have a different case, you can go with that. So do you plan in working in the following categories? I just select no. Will you be coming to Canada under a active public policy or special measure announced by ARCC? No. Are you a spouse, common law partner of a dependent child of a person who has or is applying for a work permit or a study permit or is a full-time student at a university? So this matches our case. Here we select yes. Have you recently graduated from a participating Canadian post-secondary institution? If your situation is that, you can select. But since the applicant is still back in India, I select no. Your marital status, I select married. What is your province or province of destination? You can select Ontario, or if you are having BC or Alberta, can select according to your profile. So you are eligible for applying for an open work permit outside Canada. This is what it shows, so I'm gonna give continue. What type of work permit do you want to apply for? So this, you want to select this one, a work permit for a spouse, common law partner of a skilled worker or international student. You select that option and click next. Are you accompanying a family member that has a status in Canada? So your spouse is here, so you select yes. Have you committed, been arrested or been charged? No. Have you had a medical exam performed by IRCC within last 12 months? If you are a new applicant, you won't be, your medical examination might not be done, so you select no. So they'll ask you to do a medical exam. Have you visited or lived in any one of the designated countries in last year? Six consecutive months in last year. So you probably will be in India, so you have to select yes. Based on the answer, you need to get a medical exam performed by an authorized doctor. You may continue with your application. Click next. Do you want to submit an application for a family member? So if you are having your kids or child, you can select yes, or if you are not, you can select no and click next. Are you giving someone access to your application? No. If you are doing by all alone by yourself, you can select no. In past years, have you given your fingerprints, like a biometrics? If you have not done, you can click no, or if you have, you can click yes. So there won't be any fees for biometrics. I'll be, I think, $85. There are fees associated with application. Yes, I'm willing to pay my fees. Are you able to make digital copies of your documents? Yes, I'm able to make it. So I'll be making card payments. Yes. So these are the questions you have answered. You can edit these questions anytime you want. Based on your options and your answers, the application will change accordingly. So once you can verify everything once more, and you can click continue. So let's start submitting our documents and application. So you'll receive a document checklist and all the informations needed. Let's start filling our main application form. This is the main application form, IMM1295, and these are the supporting documents. Like I have already explained few of this, rest I'll be explaining. So you'll be having to pay a total fee of $340. Let's start doing our applications. So the first main application, I will click and download it. Download it to my system. I'll download that IMM1295E to my desktop. So let's start filling up. So if you are a new applicant and if you don't have a UCI number, you can leave it blank. You can select English. The applicant should give the family name, your name, no other given names. If you don't have any other names, you select your gender, you give your date of birth, place of birth, citizenship. I'm just skimming through the sections, not filling it. Current country of residence, you can select India, or based on your status, you can change it. And during the past 5 years, have you lived in any other country or territory other than your country of citizenship? If not, you can select no. If you have, you can fill those. Country of territory where you're applying. So if you are applying from India itself, you can select yes. If not, you can select no and give those details. And if you are married, click this one and write your spouse name, that is the international student's name, family name and given name, and the date of marriage. Have you previously been married? Select no. If not, languages. Native language, you can select whatever according to your selections. And give your passport number, country of issue, usually India in this case. Issue, you can give the issue date, expiry date, and national identity document. I selected no. I don't have a USPR card, no. So in this form, if we can give your home address, like you are submitting the application, and if it's the same, you can give that. You can give a phone number. If you are giving a Canadian phone number, you can give that here. For all communications, you give an email ID. It does not have to be the same email ID like you have, or you can give any email ID which you will be using to get the notifications from IRCC. The type of work permit you are applying for, it's an open work permit, you select that. You don't have an employer, so you can give it blank. can fill this, like you can give Ontario or BC or based on your choice. You can give a job title if you want, like you are planning to work as a team member, crew member, supervisor or any other position. You can give a brief regarding your college and education, if you, and you can give your employment status and all, company and the dates from which you are employed. So within the past 2 years, have your family member had a tuberculosis? No. Have you been physically mental disorder? No. Have you been remind beyond the validity of a status in the school with authorization? No. Have you refused a visa? No. Apply previous application? No. So, but if your case is different and if you have already applied and refused a visa, you can give yes and give a reason, like when, what, when it happened and when did you do that. You can give a small details for the immigration officer to know your situation. Have you been convicted or arrested? No. Have you been in military? No. Have you been a member associated with a political party? No. No. So pretty much everything is done. You can type your name and the date of maybe the today's date, and you can click validate. And this, if everything is right, because I have not filled a few columns, so it will show an error. If you click validate, family name is not there. So yeah, so when everything you have filled in right, this will generate a barcode. You can save it and keep it in your system for uploading. So once you have completed the application, the main application, that is IMM 1295, you can validate it and upload it from the system. So this application, you cannot modify or attach any other more further information. This application should be alone and it should be attached as is. But it's not the case with the supporting documents. Here you can give more information with each documents. So the first document is the family information form, that's IMM 5707. So this mainly contains the family information of yours, your spouse, and if you have kids and all. So here you can give more details about the international student. So I have done that way. So you can download this one, and this form will be this one, IMM 5707, family information. You can give the name of the applicant and fill all these forms: date of birth, present occupation, the name of the international student or spouse who is here in Canada, and give a Canadian address, and give occupation as student, and name of your mother, father, details. And you don't have to fill this or sign this one, but if you do have kids, you enter this section, and if you don't have any kids, you should sign this one. So I suggest taking a printout and signing it and scanning it back again as a digital copy. Once you are done, you can sign at the last, and this document will be filled. While I attached and created my family information along with the IMM 5707 form, I attached more information of the international student. So I completed this information. I took a printout and did the signatures as required, and I also attached a letter along with this form. So I have given a model for reference for you. You can do something like this, or I have also given a link to download this letter in my description if you want to use this information. So what I did is I wrote a letter stating I'm writing you this letter to explain details of my wife. Say if the wife is an international student here in Canada and the husband is applying from home country, and you can give the international student's name, holder of passport, in which college, and I recommend submitting follow these documents as I mentioned before. So this is the structure I used. I have given the passport, counterfoil, study permit, work permit, letter of acceptance, enrollment letter, student ID card, transcripts, and I also given the place I am working, the company name, and attached my paystub. So this is will be a model I start attaching my passport images, visa images, and something like study permit. I keep a picture of my study permit if you have a work permit. So you can just follow this method if you want to give more information and attach with the family information document, like or include all these details and make a single PDF file. By I did through online PDF mergers and PDF Word to PDF converters and created a single document and attached in a family information tab. So go here. Once you have done and made all the documents, you can upload it here. So after uploading family information, next is uploading your passport. You can go upload it here, your digital photo, a single passport size photo of yours. Next is a request for medical exam. You click here and download the medical request form. So it will look something like this, a request for a medical exam, because you have to do an exam if you have not done in last 12 months. So you can click yes and upload that here for a request for medical exam. Next one is the proof of relationship. For this I have done a letter, and this is a little important if you are newly married, like closely 1 year or less than 2 years. So you have to prove you are in a genuine marital relationship to the officer. So this is the model of the letter I have used for the application to show the proof of relationship. So in this one, I started the letter like this. I am writing you this letter to explain my relationship with the name of the international student. We know each other. For you how to show how I did my things. I attached 2 photos before our marriage when we were together, and we decided to get married, and I gave the dates, months and all. So this letter is attached in the description down below, and if you can download it if you want to see it more clearly. And in this letter I have attached copy of my wedding invitation letter, marriage certificates from the government, marriage certificates from the church or temple, and details of photographs of wedding and honeymoon. So like I have given each heading and attached more details of each. So you can use this reference to prove your relationship. So it does not have to be like, don't attach a single marriage certificate as a proof of relationship. Give more details so that you can prove your relationship is genuine. Attach images and all, and do diligence and make your own letter. Use this as a reference if you want. So once you done with your proof of relationship letter, attaching all the images of your marriage certificate, photographs, etc. So this is important only if you are married in like less than a year or so. If you are having a long longer than like 5 years and you are having kids and all, you can just attach a marriage certificate, that'll be fine. Next one is the application for a temporary resident visa made outside Canada. Even though it's an optional document, this is important because this is a visa counterfoil printing application. So you have to have this to travel to Canada. So this is important. You can click and download IMM5257 and it will look something like this. Application for temporary residence, you have to fill your details. I can probably mostly these will be options no, and if your case is different you can click yes and give more details and hit validate. Once you are done, and save it and upload the file as it is here. And next one is the client information. This is the place where I gave more information about myself. So I have created a letter for that, and I have given that letter in the description. You can find it, download it, and use that as your reference for creating your client information. I will show what I did for doing mine. So here, this was a letter I made. The yellow highlighted things are just for, you can change it if you are using this letter. I am writing you this letter to explain some details about myself, my education, trainings or experience, and my financial background. Please find the explanation below. I attached my educational certificates and my experience certificates here. Later, I gave a statement like, I am financially stable by having a total Indian rupees, which is equivalent to Canadian dollars, in my bank accounts as term deposits and saving account. So attach a bank balance statement. It should be a bank letterhead, so it will be more genuine. Get a letterhead from your bank. You can go talk to the assistant managers. They will get you your account details in a bank letterhead. So I have done also a chartered accountant asset evaluation, which with all the assets I have, my properties, if I have any belongings, and I have done asset evaluation with. I've also mentioned the total sum of the assets in Indian rupees, as well as I converted into Canadian dollars. For to be in the safe side, I also added parents' bank statement affidavits, and this was a statement I would like to inform that my parents have agreed to incur all the incidental expense during my stay in Canada. My parents signed an affidavit stating the same, and notary has attested it. So the details I gave, my calculator, the total amount in Indian rupees and converted it into Canadian dollars, and gave those letterhead and notary attested affidavits in my applications. So I have attached everything in this letter itself. I've made multiple PDF documents and attached and made a single file, so that attach in one document as a client information. This, like this way, I entered the document, and you can download this and use as a reference for your application. So once done, I uploaded my file here, and once you upload everything, there will be an option to click next for the payments. You can click next and do the payments and submit the application. In my case, it just took 10 days to get my application approved. And within 5 days, I got my request for biometrics, and within 8 days, I got my request for medical, and next 2 days, I got the request for submitting my passport for stamping the counterfoil in the visa. Thank you for watching. Share your thoughts and questions in the comments down below. Please do support the channel. Have a good one.